7 Sports presents University of Dayton Basketball. This evening, the Dayton Flyers take on the Southern Jaguars live from the University of Dayton Arena, Dayton, Ohio. Brought to you by the Ohio Lottery. Play the Ohio Lottery. You could be a big winner, too. By Kroger. Go Flyers and go Krogering, where you really do get the best for a whole lot less. By your Lincoln Mercury Dealers Association. Visit your Dayton Metro Lincoln Mercury Dealers today. And by these participating sponsors, Community Mutual Blue Cross and Blue Shield, the strength to lead, and Cellular One, there's only one.
We're live at the University of Dayton Arena, where tonight the Dayton Flyers play host to the Southern Jaguars from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Hi, everybody. I'm Mike Hartsock, along with John Condit, and this is going to be racehorse basketball at its best because these two teams average somewhere in the neighborhood of 215 points a game between them, John.
That's right. Dayton averages 90 a game. The Jaguars average 123. These two teams last year set a UD Arena record for scoring when they scored 219 points. Expect the same kind of performance tonight.
Talk about scoring. The Jaguars feature the highest scorer in the country. Bobby Phils, 38 points a game.
Great three-point shooter, averages close to 38 a game, as you mentioned. He will shoot the ball every time he is open. He took 38 shots against UAB in a losing effort earlier this week.
Now the Flyers will counter with a couple of lineup changes. Chip Jones will start for Norm Grevy at the shooting guard, and Al Sicard goes for Sam Howard.
Yeah, this is no kind of a punishment after the Miami blowout, but this will be the best defensive lineup Jim O'Brien can put on the floor. The quickest and the best, and hopefully that will force more turnovers.
John, you'll remember it was last year when Southern beat Dayton here that Jim O'Brien chastised the Flyer fans for leaving the game early. He doesn't want to see that. That won't happen here tonight.
I don't think so, because he knows that if it's close, the Flyers can come back, and the crowd in the stand is that oh-so-important sixth man.
So it's the Flyers and the Jaguars here at the University of Dayton Arena. We'll be back with more right after this.
Time now for our scouting report before tonight's ball game with Flyers head coach Jim O'Brien. And coach, this is a racehorse basketball team you're going up against. 123 points a game.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome and a little bit intimidating. But we know what to expect of them. We've had too long to prepare for them. The last 9 days, Mike, since the Miami game have been the longest 9 days probably of my life.
Now, I don't care who you're playing against. The team that scores 123 points has to have some pretty good athletes.
They have great athletes. They had them last year, and they have an abundance of them this year. And that's one of the reasons why we're going to the quicker and shorter lineup that we're going with.
A couple of changes in the lineup. You're putting Al Sicard in, and you're putting Chip Jones in the starting lineup.
Yeah, a couple reasons for that. One, the quickness. Al Sicard and Chip Jones, along with Alex and Derek, give us extreme pressure on the ball. They get a lot of deflections. The other thing, we think Norm is better off coming off the bench. He has done that his whole career. We think he can be a super six man. And we're going to give Antoine Smith a look at the backup behind Al Sicard.
You talked about the long layoff. Is it a concern? The guys have had a long time to think about that, the first loss of the season.
It's tough to say. You don't want to ever use any excuses. I think we've had plenty of time to prepare for Southern. We should be ready. We've practiced just about every day with the exception of the day off that we had after the Miami game. I think we're rested, and I think we're ready to go.
Okay, Jim O'Brien, thanks very much, and best of luck tonight. We'll be back with the introduction of the starting lineups right after this.
The score from last year's ball game, 114-105. That was an arena scoring record at that time. We all thought that was something else, John, but tonight may surpass that.
Ben Jobe, the coach for Southern, says he's been running this style of play for 20 years. He has a lifetime record of 366 and 163 losses. He likes the up-tempo, and his players like to play it because everybody gets to score. And again, I think we are in for a great shootout here at the arena tonight.
You're going to see a lot of threes thrown up, but for Southern's side, only one player, and that is Bobby Phils. He has shot 56 of them already, 56 of the 69. Now, the Flyers have made 39. That means $3,900 for the caring program for children from Community Mutual and Cellular One. Bobby Phils will take about 20 threes a game.
He will take the shot every time he's open. He will come down on the right wing and plant, and it's the point guard's job to get it to him. If you don't put your hands up in his face, he's going to shoot right over you. He's a great shooter.
Southern leads the series. One thing to point out, one thing to watch for tonight is when the Flyers make a basket, watch for Bobby Fields. He just takes off down the other way. He'll run this near sideline that you're seeing on your picture right now. Bobby Fields will run that sideline and just take off. They want him to have the ball and to make the offense get going. And Bobby Fields is going to do a lot of running today.
And the Flyers have adjusted their press because of that. We'll talk about that in just a minute.
Okay, time for the introduction of our starting lineup. So let's go to public address announcer Johnny Robinson.
And welcome to the University of Dayton Arena for tonight's game between the University of Dayton Flyers and the Southern University Jaguars of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Introducing the starting lineup for the Southern Jaguars. At forward, a 6'5 senior from Pontiac, Michigan, number 25, Derek Williams.
Just eligible, he's a transfer from Sam Houston State.
At the other forward, a 6'7 senior from Mobile, Alabama, number 33, Dwayne Tang.
Averaging 14 rebounds a game.
At center, a 6'7 senior from Union Springs, Alabama, number 45, Robert Youngblood.
24 points and 10 rebounds, a good one.
At one guard, a 6'4 junior from Moultrie, Georgia, number 15, Irwin Harper.
He's averaging 12 points a game.
And at the other guard, a 6'4 senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, number 34, Bobby Fields.
37 points a game.
Ben Jobe, assisted by Tommy Green and Will Cutchery.
Ben Jobe has 366 career wins.
The University of Dayton Flyers. At forward, a 6'4 sophomore from Chicago, number 24, Alex Robertson.
11 and a half points and 5 rebounds a game.
At the other forward, a 6'4 sophomore from Dayton, Ohio, number 22, Al Sakar.
Making his first start of the season.
At center, a 6'11 junior from New Lebanon, Ohio, number 52, Wes Coffey.
6 points and 5 rebounds for Wes.
At one guard, a 6'1 junior from Cincinnati, number 32, Chip Jones.
The Flyers' leading scorer, 14 points a game.
And at the other guard, a 6-foot freshman from Cincinnati, number 12, Derek Dukes.
Derek with 6 points a game.
The Flyers are coached by Jim O'Brien, assisted by Doc Conroy, Tom McConnell, Butch Carter, and Larry Miller.
Jim O'Brien once again going for his 100th career coaching victory in the college ranks. Our officials tonight, Glenn Mayborg, Jerry Siebert, and Denny Friend will be calling the action. They are out of the Midwestern Collegiate Conference, and we're ready for basketball on a Saturday night. Glad to have you along with us on WHIO-TV Dayton Springfield as the Flyers and the Jaguars get ready to run it up and down the court. Southern is not maybe as deep as the Flyers, John, but they're probably in better shape.
Exactly, and both teams coming off a loss. So this is a gut check for both teams, both having come off their first loss of the season. We'll see who wants it more, and this will be a shootout, Mike.
Okay, here we go. Good crowd on hand. Students pretty much on vacation right now. They're on break.
Still a pretty good crowd.
Yeah, it doesn't show at all because there's at least 12,000 in here tonight. Stepping in is Robert Youngblood against Wes Coffey. Youngblood to go up with it. Tip controlled by the Flyers. That's Derek Dukes. Pushing it up, bounce past to Chip Jones. He's one-on-one with Williams. Matchup zone, almost stolen away. Dukes penetrates, dishes. Chip Jones from 12, short with it. Rebound comes down to the big guy, Dwayne Tanks. Here comes Southern. Inside feed to Youngblood. He's triple teamed. Somebody's got to be open. There's Williams in the corner for three.
Youngblood did a nice job of drawing the defenders to him, opening up that shot.
And back the other way, it's Chip Jones for the jam.
Good hustle by Jones to get down court after that basket.
Flyers pressing. Southern breaks it. That's Williams. Up top to Harper. Here he is. Bobby Fields misses it, but it's tipped in by Tanks. Dwayne Tanks
leads his team in rebounds with 13 a game.
Alex Robertson across the timeline, top of the key. Derek Dukes way off the mark. Southern on the run, stolen away by Dukes. He loses the ball, but gets it back. Nice hustle.
Derek Dukes is leading the MCC in steals.
Alex Robertson inside. There's Sicard working down low. And he throws it away, but it's off Southern. You know, I was talking to the Flyer coaching staff, and they were telling me that Southern coaching staff admits they want to get a shot off in 8 seconds or less.
That's basically their policy. When they have the ball, every 8 seconds get a shot off. And the difference in this game is Dayton giving them just one shot.
Alex Robertson with the ball in the corner. That's Chip Jones for three. Way long with it. The rebound comes down. Harper up court to Phils to the basket, lays it in.
Once again, Phils getting down court right away, and that's why he got the layup.
Stolen away, Bobby Phils. 15-footer off the glass, too hard. Youngblood the rebound, back up and in.
Whenever Youngblood gets the ball, he likes to dribble first and then square up with the basket.
9-2, Southern by 7. Chip Jones pulls up for 3 and nails it.
Need to get him hot for Dayton to do well in this game.
We got the net wrapped up, so we're going to have to get that down. Slow Southern down for just a little bit.
One thing Dayton will do here, Mike, as we watch Southern take the ball out. They are not going to have a man on the ball. Normally, McCourt or West is on the ball. Not tonight. They don't want to get burned down court by Phils.
Right now, it's Southern 9, Chip Jones 5. That's Phils. He'll try another 3. Misses again. But Tanks has the offensive board. Back up too hard. Rebound up and in. Missed again, but tipped in by Dwayne Tanks.
Dayton will lose this game if they don't do better on the boards than that.
And they got to control the ball a little bit better. That one was thrown away. It is 11-5, a 6-point Jaguar lead.
The UD coaching staff believe they can give Southern one shot and that's it.
Williams for 3.
That's 2 for Williams, a good outside shooter.
Derek Williams with 2 threes. It is a 14-5 ball game. Outcourt pressure giving the Flyers some trouble right now. Alex going to take it inbounds. Flyers have the number, 3-on-1. Coffey to the basket for the reverse.
Nice move to the basket by Wes Coffey.
Look out, back the other way. Youngblood misses the shot, tipped around, thrown out of bounds off Southern. Boy, you see just exactly what Southern will do now. As soon as the Flyers make it, they're back the other way just that quickly. Robertson looking for somebody, stolen away. Harper to the basket.
Right now, the Southern press has Dayton a little bit out of sync.
Dukes gets the inbounds pass. And almost throws it away. It's knocked out of bounds off Bobby Phils.
It's important that Derek Dukes and Alex Robertson get a feel for bringing this ball up court in this press. As soon as they learn to handle the pressure, it'll make for an easier transition for the Flyers.
Here's Al Sicard just inside the three-point line. That one's so good. Here comes Southern. Harper throws it away. Throw it behind Dwayne Tanks. And the Flyers will come back with it. Now, somebody needs to help the guards get the ball inbounds right now. That's the problem right now. Nobody's setting a pick to get open. There's Al Sicard in trouble. Goes to Dukes. Flyers across the timeline. Dukes down the lane. Dishes off. Coffey outside. Alex Robertson for 3.
Good penetration towards the basket. They kick it back out for an easy three-pointer.
Back the other way. It's Bobby Phils. Scoops it in.
He shoots well from the outside, and he's not afraid to go right for the basket.
Phils has 4. Flyers have the numbers. Here's Chip Jones.
Dayton getting hot from three-point land. That's important.
That's another $100 donation from Cellular One and Community Mutual for the caring program for children. Knocked out of bounds. West Coffey hustling, but he couldn't get it. Here comes Norm Greavy, Antoine Smith, David Brad into the Flyer lineup, and Sean Strutchen.
Jim O'Brien believes Southern may be the best athletic team the Flyers face all season long. Consequently, he is going to get fresh bodies in there as quickly as possible to tire down the Jaguars.
18-13 our score. Makor Shiok in the ballgame as well. Flyers down by 5. Youngblood throws up a prayer and it goes in. He had 2 defenders on him.
Basket by Robert Youngblood.
Norm Greavy loses the ball. Bobby Phils slaps it away. Youngblood's all alone. And he's fouled by Antoine Smith.
Nice job by Smith not to give Youngblood the easy basket. He was probably going to slam that. Good positioning. That's a foul on Antoine Smith.
That is the first foul of the ball game, and we've almost played 4 minutes.
First.
Whenever Youngblood gets the ball, not in this case because it was on a break, he will put his back to the basket, put the ball on the floor, and try to push the defender back with his dribble. Here he goes up strong, and Smith denies an easy two.
Youngblood gets the first one. 21-13. It is now a 9-point lead.
Youngblood averaging 24 points a game.
Thor gets it inbounds. There's stretches. Down the corner to Greavy for three. Right it down.
Dayton hitting the three-pointer, and exactly what O'Brien wanted, Norm, to come off the bench like that.
Back the other way, Williams, a long three, misses it. Battled inside, it's out of bounds, off Southern. Of course, Sheehock really battling for it. Well, that was an NBA three that Williams threw up. We have a timeout. 15:58 left in the first half. It's Southern 22, Dayton 16.
A Television 7 special tomorrow late afternoon. The Aviation Hall of Fame, News Center 7's Jim Baldridge and Deborah Countess take you behind the scenes of an unusual museum to honor air and space pioneers here in the Dayton birthplace of aviation. That's at 5:30 on Television 7, the Miami Valley News Leader.
22-16 is our score, just inside 16 minutes to play. The Flyers, that is not a correct stat according to my numbers here. Southern has 11 rebounds. Dayton has none, according to the official stats.
Amazing if that's the case that Dayton trails by just 6 points. Dayton can give Southern one shot. They then have to crash the board and deny them a second and third attempt at their end.
Flyers trying to inbound it. There's Antoine Smith. And the Flyers throw it away, or do they? Yes, they do. You know, it's not a trapping press all that much that Southern is putting on. They're just so quick.
Exactly.
Here's Harper with the basketball. That's Phil. Double team. Somebody's open. It's Harper. Top of the key to the foul line. Jumper on the way. Good.
David Brads needs to get in his face a little bit.
There's a foul on Harper.
Take a look at Sean Strutchins. He has the right thigh wrapped. He has a muscle pull. He was questionable for tonight's game, but I had a feeling Sean wasn't going to miss this one.
Take a look at it right here. Harper gets him on the inbounds pass. They just put so much pressure on that press. Score at Kroger this week on some great features. 24-16, an 8-point Southern lead. That's Norm Greavy. Up top, Antoine Smith. Greavy in the corner. He has Phil's right there. Check that, Williams with him. To Strutchins. He's open from 17. Short with it. Rebound to Antoine Smith. He'll put it up on the baseline. Good.
Antoine Smith was impressive down in Oxford at Miami, and that's why he's coming in before Sam Howard tonight.
Antoine's getting some confidence. Phil's for a long three. Rims out of there. Rebound to Tanks.
Once again, Southern gets a second chance.
Phil's will try another three. Missed again. And Makor Sheehock finally clears the board, looking for somebody to throw to. There he is. Sean Strutchins quickly up in the corner. Three from Brad. No good. Somebody get it. Flyers all in the basket. The ball came out. Down the lane. Harper scoops it in.
David Pratt needs to follow his shot. Norm Greavy open here.
Greavy on the dribble in the corner. Brad's open again. Doesn't shoot. Greavy will for three. Yes.
That was about a 23-footer by Greavy. Nice shot.
Greavy with a pair of three. Harper inside. There's Tanks on the baseline. He beats Sheehock.
Very important that Sheehock and Westhoff get position inside.
28-21. Flyers down by seven. Strutchins pushing the ball up the court. Down the lane. Nobody stops him, and he drives but misses it. Misses the easy shot, and nobody got in his way. Phil inside. That's Youngblood. Spins, fakes, shoots. Tough shot. There's an offensive rebound again. And a foul on Antoine Smith as Derek Williams uncontested on the boards.
That's going to be two on Smith if it was Antoine. Right now, Jim O'Brien trying to figure out how to get some rebounding help. And perhaps Wes Coffey coming in with Al Sicard along with Derek Dukes, Alex Robertson, and Chip Jones might be the answer. But right now, Southern beating Dayton at their end of the court on the boards.
Starting five back in the ballgame again.
Watch it again. Youngblood loves to put the ball on the floor and try to get you kind of off balance, and then, like lightning, he'll go right for the basket.
Now, I'm not saying it's going to happen tonight, folks, but
earlier this season against Texas College. Southern scored 96 points in the second half. 96 points in one half. That's 8 points for Williams and a 9-point Southern lead, 30-21. Derek Dukes in the corner to Jones. Flyers working around the zone. Alex Robertson, a long three.
The Flyers are on from three-point land, and O'Brien wants them to take better shots from out there.
Williams, and shot. Dukes the rebound up court. Jones all alone, tipped to the basket. He's hammered. That should be two. That should be intentional, but he's not going to get the call.
Great pass from his former high school teammate, Derek Dukes. Could have been a little bit further because he had to kind of wait for it, but great body control. Look at Jones. I don't know how he got that up there so effectively.
That should have been an intentional foul call. You saw the defender wrapping his arm around and just grabbing a hold. The official may have been screened out from that, but that should have been an intentional foul call.
Chip Jones, a 78% shooter from the free throw line.
Misses the second. West Coffee had a hand on it, but couldn't get it away. 30-25. Flyers trail by five. Bobby Phil. The Harper as they swing around, looking inside. Phil. The tank. Offensive foul as he bowls West Coffee over.
He knocked West Coffee down to Miamisburg almost. That was incredible. Watch it again. He just throws himself into Coffee. Offensive foul.
Take a look at it right here. Watch Wes go right head over heels. He took the brunt of that one. 30-25.
Tanks is a great rebounder, though.
Alex Robertson across the timeline. Drives around the foul line. Somebody's got to be open. There's the cut inside the Coffee, and there's a foul inside on Tanks. And that's two quick ones on Dwayne Tanks.
West Coffee posting up. He was ready for the lob or bounce pass from Al Sicard. And he gets a shove from Tanks. 2,000, about 20 seconds for that guy.
Ben Jobe has not substituted at all yet. Flyers have brought the fresh troops in a couple of times. Alex Robertson double clutches and nails it.
Nice fake. Great job at faking the three and shooting from the free throw line.
Alex Robertson has eight. It's a three-point game. Drop pass. Youngblood on the baseline. Triple team. Offensive foul should be. No, he walked.
Once again, you watch Youngblood put the ball on the floor, and he was going to try to itch his way back towards the basket. Instead, he traveled. Right now, the Flyers are doing a pretty decent job at defending him.
Flyers getting some momentum.
In that Texas college game, 159 points, 96 points and a half, and 94-point margin of victory. All records for Southern University.
Derek Dukes will bring it across for the Flyers. Dukes gets the pick out of the key. Alex is open for three more. The rainbow misses. West Coffee has the offensive rebound, but he couldn't control it.
Flyers shooting pretty well from three-point land. They're going to keep throwing them up.
They've already made six threes. Outside, they leave him alone. Fadeaway jumper. He misses it. Rebound. Tanks again. Misses. And finally, Al Sicard skies, and Dwayne Tanks has his third personal foul.
That's big. With 12:16 to play in the first half, Dwayne Tanks getting in foul trouble. That is big for the Flyers. Tanks averages just over 13 rebounds a game. That's big.
Al Sicard really got up that time. Watch it right here from the low angle. Sicard going to sky for it after this shot right here. Here's the tip. Sicard way up to get it, and Flyers over his back.
The Flyers really have to box out better, though. They're holding their own at 30-27 right now. They have to box out better.
Flyers with a second five in the ballgame again. Here's David Brad. Brad's across the line looking for somebody. That's Greavy in the corner for three. No good. Rebound comes down to Williams. Here comes Southern. Out pass inside. Greavy can't control it out of bounds. 30-27, 12:02 left to play first half.
Give credit to Scrutchins and David Brads. They were very effective at getting back on that.
Well, we got a horn blow, but the play didn't stop, and it's tipped in.
Harper with the tip.
Harper has eight. in the corner, David Brad.
Harper.
Makoa Shiok with the ball. There's Brad. He'll try three. No good. Greavy the rebound. Fake shoot. Can't get it to go. Brad picks up the loose ball. Greavy again. Penetrate. Tissue. Brad for three. No good. Lions can't buy a bucket.
David Brad said he felt good in the warm-ups, but so far he's missed four from three-point range.
Harper to Youngblood on the baseline. Short with a shot. Lions battle for it. Strutchins comes out of there with it. And he stepped out of bounds with the pressure.
Sean Strutchins really had a good final 3 minutes of basketball down at Oxford against Miami, but he's having trouble getting going here tonight against Southern.
Timeout on the floor, 11:19 left to play in the first half. It's Southern 32, Dayton 27.
Back here at the University of Dayton Arena, our score, Southern 32, Dayton 27.
Southern with a basketball right now. They've got a couple of subs in the ballgame. That's Robert Youngblood. Has it stolen away. Loose ball on the floor. Who's going to get it? Jump ball, and it's going to be
Southern's ball.
Southern ball.
Arrow pointing towards Southern, which means the next time that would come about, the possession will go for the Flyers, but I believe it's going to be Southern's basketball. Youngblood down on the floor, scrambling for possession.
Say, the one thing that has been obvious here in the first half that is going to have to stop if the Flyers are going to win this game is rebounding.
Absolutely.
Southern has 21 rebounds, Dayton has 7.
Yet they trail by just 5. That's amazing.
Flyers with 46% from three-point country. Here's Bobby Phils driving, shooting, missing. And Makor Shiok rips it off the board.
That's the way O'Brien wants Shiok to rebound.
Stretches inside. Howard fake shoot. He's fouled. It doesn't go, but a foul called on the inside on Torrance Williams, a 6'6 sophomore. Watch right here. Great shot fake. And he got him with the leg.
You can bet Sam Howard's a little bit angry. He didn't start. He knows he hasn't been playing up to his potential, and this is senior season. I look for a good game from Sam Howard off the bench.
Looking for a new or used car? Be sure to visit your Lincoln Mercury dealers today.
Sam's a 67% free throw shooter.
Ben Joe, veteran coach.
Southern this year has beaten Nichols State, Texas State, and then they lost to Alabama Birmingham in their last outing.
That's Matt Guillory with the ball right there. Guillory's a 6-foot senior. Backup point guard. Williams loses it, now gets it back. He's the transfer. This is his first game in a Southern uniform. It's stolen away. David Brad stops and pops. No good. Nobody went after the rebound. That was a bad shot. Back the other way. Robert Youngblood jammed it home.
Robert Youngblood was the Southwestern Athletic Conference pre-center for the season.
Going away. Bobby Phils for three. He's short with it. He'll get it back and shoot again. Bobby Phils has 6. Flyers trail by 7. Pushing it up court. Cross court and thrown away by David Brad.
Right now, the Flyers just a little bit out of rhythm. The press obviously giving him some problems, and David Brad's just threw that way too high.
Here comes the first 5 back into the ballgame. Dukes and Jones and Robertson and Coffee and Sakar.
Finishing my thought on Youngblood, what I meant to say there, he was the Southwestern Athletic Conference best center in the preseason, so he's expected to do big things this year.
Swinging around the outside, the Flyers playing a matchup zone. Up top, there he is, Bobby Phils. He's not been on from three-point land. He's not made one yet. Derek Duke penetrates to Alex Robertson, takes the three, now puts it on the floor, off the glass, and good.
Nice move. He went right over Williams.
Alex has 10. It's a 5-point ball game again. Williams out front to Guillory. I tell you, these Southern shooters, you can't back off of them a foot. They're going to take that shot. Guillory to Bills up top. There's Williams. He'll shoot the jumper. Way off. Rebound. Up and in.
Look like Williams maybe pushed Sam Howard.
Or Lawrence Williams. Lawrence Williams gets the bucket. Now Alex Robertson, a long three.
Oh, my. That was a rainbow. His third three-pointer of the contest.
Another $100 for the folks from Caring Program for Children. From the Cellular One and Community Mutual. Phil, he gets three.
Excellent. Shooting on the run. He barely had time to set up, and he nailed it.
Here's Chip Jones, top of the key. Chip on the move down the lane, puts it up and in.
Nice drive, go right to the glass. Chances are you either get the shot or get fouled.
41-36. Stolen away, Chip Jones loses it back. Well, Guillory throws it, and it's through the legs of Williams. Here comes Kenny Branch back into the ball game for the first time.
Once again, we saw a couple deflections and a couple steals there. Jones, I think, saw an open slam dunk and tried to leave before he had the basketball, but this is a quick team on the floor, although now Howard and Sheok checking back in.
Sam Howard and McCore Sheok in. Southern's going to back off for once. This is one of the few times up the court they haven't pressed. Kenny Branch, top of the key with it. Branch. Looking up top, there's Jones open. Now puts it on the floor. Dipsy Doodle, no good. Rebound battled for. Sam Howard leans in, partially blocked. Tries again, it counts.
Great effort by Sam Howard. He was battling under the board. The second effort, he gets the foul and the basket. And again, I think Sam's a little angry tonight.
Sam Howard doing it right here. Watch it. Going up hard, getting the basket and a foul.
And this UD Arena crowd starting to get a little bit more into it. Some noise might rattle this Jaguar squad.
The foul goes on Derek Williams. He has two. Howard trying to complete the three-point play. And the Flyers are within a basket.
Sam 3-for-3 from the free throw line.
Here comes Southern on the run. Matt Guillory, top of the key with it. There's Phil. He'll shoot another three and knock it down.
Once again, shooting on the run, barely had position. This guy, you have to get your hands in his face.
He has 12 now. Branch down the lane. Stop, shoot, score.
Kenny Branch just getting into this ball game. He scores right away.
If you're a purist of defense, you're watching the wrong ball game. 44-41. Guillory. Stop, Phil shoots another three. Three in a row.
He's on fire.
He has 15, and Chip Jones back the other way.
Great pass and great body control from the left side for the layup by Jones.
47-43. We still have 7.5 minutes left to play in the first half.
Jones has 11 points now.
Matt Guillory. Here's Williams. They're looking to get Phil's open. There he is. Chip Jones right with it. Phil, fadeaway jumper. Too high off the glass. Rebound, Sam Howard. And the Flyers kick it out. Chip Jones jacks it down, saves it in, but nobody's there but blue shirt. Guillory pushing it up court. Nice feed inside to Youngblood for the jam.
The crowd wanted a technical foul. They thought Youngblood hung on the rim.
You're allowed to hang on the rim if somebody's under you. Three for Alex, no good, a foul. And it's on Southern. On the big guy inside, Torrence Williams. You know, you talk about that slam dunk, that last slam dunk. The crowd wanted a technical foul. If there's somebody under you, if you're trying to avoid an injury, you can hang on the rim. That's perfectly legal.
Right, for safety reasons.
Flyers put a fresh five back in the ballgame. It's Greavy in there with Dukes, Sheok, Sicard, and Brad.
You saw Ben Jobe, the head coach for Southern, 90-37 with this club.
McCore Sheok at the line. Flyers have committed only two personal fouls here in the first half. Southern is over the limit. They have eight. Free throw missed. 49-43, Southern by six. 6:40 left to play first half. There's Phils again. On the move, baseline, short with a jumper. McCore pulls off the rebound. McCore loses the ball, now gets it back. It's on the floor, and Southern tracks it down. Phils, fadeaway three, that's no good. But they get another rebound. Inside, wide open. A missed shot, wide open, and there's a foul. Lincoln Browder. That's a wide open layup.
That's his first foul. Again, Dayton getting beat on the board.
Lincoln Browder is another player that's playing his first game in a Southern uniform, just becoming eligible tonight. Give the gift of gab with Cellular One's Common Sense Holiday Gift.
While Southern's averaging 123 points a game, they've been holding their opponents to 86 on the average.
Al Sicard has yet to score tonight. Sophomore out of Chaminade, Julianne misses the free throw. David Brads puts it back up. It doesn't go. And the Flyers get it back. Dukes penetrates, dishes, left coffee to Greasy. Greasy thinking about three, now throwing cross court to Brad. Up top, Duke puts it on the floor, down the lane, blocked away from him. Greasy gets it back for three.
Nice adjustment by Norm Greasy.
49-46. Flyers trail by three. Derek Williams. There's a foul on West Coffey, pushing from behind. It's only the third team foul on Dayton. Timeout on the floor. 5:45 left to play in the first half. It is Southern 49, Dayton 46. Ron Redland, a very, very happy birthday. It says here 38, Ron. I don't believe that. I think it's probably more like 48, but what the heck, huh? You know, one thing the Flyers have cut into other than the score is the rebounding margin. No rebound needed there because Youngblood jammed it home, but it's now 26-17, and that's the closest the Flyers have been in quite some time.
Important to box out, get position, and we've already seen that there's a little bit of pushing going on. But the rebounding has to continue for Dayton. The Lady Flyers were at the University of Kentucky this afternoon. The Lady Cats defeated UD 95-68, rather. UD's record even now at 3-3.
Back to action, and action is what we've had here in the first half. Bobby Fields, Brad's is all over him. Not going to give him that three. Inside feed, West Coffey right there. Jump ball to Dayton.
Dayton's got the arrow, possession arrow going their way. Nice job. Tommy McConnell, the assistant coach for Jim O'Brien on the bench, his hands are up. He's saying, keep your hands up. A constant reminder for the Flyers.
Flyers having trouble getting it inbounds, and they throw it off the backboard. It's Southern's ball.
Jim O'Brien's telling David Brads he's got to look up court.
And a couple of players open. 5.5 minutes left to play first half. Lobbed out front. That's Youngblood. He'll set it up to Giller. Setting picks for Phil. Flyers doing a nice job helping out. Jump shot by Browder is an air ball. Way over the basket. Here comes Derek Dukes. Greedy inside the Sicard. Al puts it on the floor. Fake shoot. Well, good. Here comes the Jaguar. Phil stops and shoots the three and rims it out. Coffey had the rebound, but Dukes gets it. Dukes to Brad. Cross court. Greedy takes the three. Drives. Scoops it up. No good.
Greedy had Brad's open on the wing. He decided to try to force one inside in heavy traffic.
Williams for three. No good. Browder has it back down the lane. Misses the shot, and Brad pulls it off.
Nice defense again by West Coffey.
4.5 minutes left to play first half. Duke right down the middle. He's fouled out front before the shot. He's fouled by Bobby Fields, and that'll be his first.
Good decision-making by the Dayton guards is important. Duke sees the lane and goes right for it. He collapses the defense. If he can't get a shot off, he's got men open on the wing. Watch now. Watch how the defense collapses. And in the corner, he's got a man if he needs to pass off. That's what O'Brien wants to see. Go towards the basket. No lateral dribbling.
Chip Jones back in the ballgame. Sam Howard is back in, along with Alex Robertson.
Derek Dukes needs to improve at the free throw line, shooting just 40%. You know, at practice for the Flyers on a weekly basis, when they're not in the actual scheme of what's going on in the center court, they're off on the sidelines, and they have to shoot three straight free throws before they can get back into the mix.
Dukes. This is that one. Rebound battle for it. Out of bounds. It's Dayton. Right off the foot of Lincoln Browner.
The crowd getting into this one now. A two will tie it. A three will put Dayton on top.
Here's Sean Scrutchins back into the ballgame. 4.5 minutes left to play in the first half.
See if Jones gets the ball here.
Comes into Alex Robertson. In the corner, Sam Howard. Puts it on the floor, kicks it back out. Chip Jones for three.
And that should light the crowd up here. Dayton on top, 50-49.
Flyers take the lead. Listen to the crowd. McCorshayot goes for the steal. He commits the foul.
The crowd kind of settling down, but they need to stay active and loud here because Southern can be rattled.
Good hustle that time by McCoy. You know, you talk about Southern being rattled, John. They've played three games, and you add up the attendance in those three games, it doesn't equal what you'll see here tonight. They've played in front of about 9,000 people. We've got about 12 or 13 here. Stolen away. Alex Robertson. Here's Scrutchins pushing it up. Drives to the foul line. Shoots.
Once again, he goes right for the basket. The defense doesn't come to him. He takes the shot. Nice job by Scrutchins.
52-49 Flyers. And there's a foul outside on Alex.
That shot by Scrutchins will hopefully add to his freshman confidence.
Jim O'Brien not liking that call one bit. It's a common foul. Only the 15th foul. Timeout on the floor. 3:44 left in the first half. Dayton 52, Southern 49.
Back here at the University of Dayton Arena, it's Dayton 52, Southern 49, and the Flyers have really taken control here in the last few minutes, and John, you pointed it out very well in the fact that it's the Dayton guards taking it right down the lane and making Southern come and play them.
That's the whole key to the offense, because that will open up shots for the three-point shooters, and more importantly, down low for Wes Coffey and McCorshayot and Sam Howard.
Southern with the ball. They trail by three. Williams, down the lane, stolen away. Sam Howard got a hand on it. He loses the ball, and it's over and back. Browder had control of it on the one side, then brought it back over to the other.
Chip Jones is such an exciting player, and he wants to light up the arena, and he wants to do exciting things, but there, he just got a little bit carried away.
Sean Scrutchins. Flyers looking to build on that lead. It's three right now. Scrutchins in trouble. There's McCorshayot. Double team down low. Kicks it out. Jones down the lane. Nice feed, McCorshayot.
Excellent penetration. That's going to be an intentional foul right there, I think. Phil's had an absolute open shot on the long pass over the defense, and he was grabbed. We'll see what they call here.
Foul is called on Sean Scrutchins, his first. You know, that showed a lot of unselfishness the last time down the floor because Chip Jones had an open shot, but he saw a guy wider, more wide open than he was.
And a guy that needs some confidence, so it's a nice dish. Fouls on Scrutchins.
And it was only a common foul. It was not a shooting foul. There's Youngblood. Fakes once, goes down. Over, Giac nails it.
Got to get your hands up in his face. Now, right now, Sam Howard needs some help.
Here's Scrutchins down the lane, kicks it out. Chip on the baseline, too hard with a shot. 54-51 Dayton. Just under 3 minutes to play in the first half. That's Matt Guillory with the ball. He's not seen Harper, the starting point guard, in a while. Williams has an open three and misses it. Tipped out. Sam Howard controls the loose ball.
The matchup defense by Dayton isn't bad tonight. They're doing okay.
Scrutchins kicks out. Robertson double team. Now the Flyers will reset. Inside it goes to Shiak. Is the jump hook coming? Yes, it is. He was bumped. Howard the rebound. No good. Tipped around. And finally, Southern comes away. They got a 4-on-1 break. Youngblood to the basket. It doesn't go, but Scrutchins fouls it.
Good defense. At first, I thought Scrutchins was just going to hack him, but he actually had good eye control to hit the ball, eye-hand control, and he... Good defense.
That ball almost went in. Youngblood was looking for a little bit of a roll there. Didn't get it. Here's a fresh five in for the Flyers. And Youngblood at the free throw line for two.
Flyers missed a good opportunity down court last time. They had three shots. None of them fell.
Now you can play cards. The Ohio Lottery's new daily game.
6'7", Robert Youngblood, 63% shooter from the free throw line, averaging 24 for the Jaguars. He hits the second one.
The one-point ball game, 54-53. Flyers up by one, 2:15 left to play, first half. There's Greavy, loses the ball, now gets it back. Inside feed, Coffey in the lane. Kicks it out to Derek Dukes. Dukes misses the shot. It comes off to Southern. Wes Coffey almost got the loose ball. Down the lane. Travel, yep.
Youngblood tried to take it right to the hoop, but he did not get a clean grab on the ball off the pass. Important to see which team goes to the locker room with the lead. A great psychological advantage for Dayton if they can hold this lead for the break.
54-53. Southern's turned it over 17 times already. The Flyers are averaging getting it 26 times from their opponent. There's Coffey in the lane. Dishes back outside. Dukes penetrates. Great feed. Sakar.
Oh, my. Once again, give credit to the guard. That time, Dukes drew the defenders towards him. Great bounce pass, and Al Sakar gave us a thrill.
A big-time jam for Sakar. The Flyers are up by three. A minute and a half left to play first half. Up top, that's Williams. Puts it on the floor down the lane. Runs in a charging foul on Williams as Wes Coffey did a nice job taking the charge.
Right now, Dayton has things going in their favor. Coffey gets position, hands straight up in the air. Perfect position to take the charge. You know, Dayton teaches their guys, jump straight up in the air. Don't jump into the basket. Jump straight up and avoid those kind of fouls when you have the ball.
Not always that easy, but here's Coffey at the free throw line.
Number 44, Lincoln Brower, back in the lineup, replacing number 25, Derek Williams.
That pass from Dukes to Sakard was pretty.
Wes Coffey at the line for Dayton, two throws.
That is the 10th team foul on Southern, so that is a two-shot free throw.
Another free throw case here, 37% for Wes Coffey. He can work on his freebies. Gets that one to fall.
It's the new rule in college basketball. After 10 fouls and a half, all fouls are two shots. Wes Coffey gives the Flyers a five-point lead, their biggest of the night. Minute 22 left to play in the first half. Harper's back in the ball game. He dribbles it and another foul on Dukes.
Derek Dukes has a real challenge trying to contain Bobby Phils, and in that case, he reached in a little bit, it looks like.
Coming up at halftime, we're going to take a closer look at one of the Flyer freshmen, redshirt freshmen, actually, John Richter, who has not seen action tonight, but John Richter is quite an athlete and quite a student.
Yes, I'd encourage you to stick around for that halftime report because I asked Coach O'Brien if he was a lot like Pete Rose in that he doesn't have natural ability, but he works hard. And the response to that was stick around for that. O'Brien, as always, candid as ever.
Bobby Phils with 16, make it 17 now.
Cuts the lead to three, 58-55, Dayton 1:15 to play.
See if the Flyers take some time off. Nope, Greavy fires up the three. It's no good. Back down in the corner by James Wagner. Southern in a hurry. There's Phils, a long three. Ho, ho, my.
Unbelievable shooter off. Squares up to the basket and jumps incredibly.
Bobby Phils has 20 first half points.
Bad choice by Sakard on that inbounds pass. Need to be a little bit more selective getting the ball inbounds, and David Brads will try it this time.
Under a minute to play at 51 seconds. We are tied at 58. So the Flyers do have to take a shot. Long court pass. It's Dukes and Coffey. Coffey to the basket.
Excellent. Excellent pass by Dukes. A nice down court pass by Brad.
Oh, and Wes almost got the steal and commits the foul. A touch-me-not foul right in front of the sideline. right in front of the southern bench.
When you play high-tempo basketball, shots will open up down court like we just saw. And we saw Youngblood get a view from southern where you're wide open, you throw the touchdown pass, and sure enough, it opens up a nice shot. This is Coffee going for the ball. Did not foul him with his hands, but with his body.
And an Academy Award, an Oscar, should have gone to Harper that time. Put on a great act.
Urban Harper at the line for Southern.
Harper scored 8.
This guy's a good free throw shooter. He's hit 80% this season. A lot of junior college transfers on this Southern team. Harper's one of them out of Bellevue Junior College.
He's looking to tie it up. Misses that one, and the rebound to the Flyers. The card out with it. Duke in the corner to Greavy. Greavy dribbles around the man, in trouble, to David Brad for 3.
And he got one finally. After 5 tries, David Brad is fired up. He hit a 3.
Flyers up by 4. 28 seconds left to play first half. Southern's actually going to hold the ball. They're going to hold it for one shot. This is rare.
20 seconds to go.
This is about as much of a stall as you will ever see out of this basketball.
They're supposed to shoot every 8 seconds, but not in this instance. 10 seconds to go here.
They're looking for Phils. Duke's denying him the ball. Inside feed. Oh, bad decision that time. Al Sicard. That ball wasn't even going to get to the basket.
Makor Shiok lost his defensive position. He gave the man the baseline. He should have put his foot out of bounds and cut it off.
Under 3 seconds to play. Got to get it up. Deuce gets the buzzer. No good. We're at halftime with the Flyers on top, 63-61. And we'll be right back.
'63-61 is our score at halftime. The Flyers and the Jaguars coming back out after a much-needed rest. Down there, they had to really rest up after playing some fast-tempo basketball.
Great athletes, but I'm not sure that they have the depth to stay with Dayton. They go about 8 deep, and we didn't see many substitutions at all, so I think that's an advantage for the Flyers at this point.
The 63 points is the most, the second most points in the first half by any Dayton team. Last year, in the first half against Xavier, in a great basketball game, the Flyers scored 65 points. That was the regular season finale.
250 points total would be a new school record, smashing the old one in the combo with Oklahoma. And that's not out of reach tonight. It would take a great second half, but there's no reason to think these guys are slowing down.
One thing the Flyers are still hurting at halftime is the rebounding department. They are being out-rebounded by 10 rebounds right now. And Southern has 16 offensive rebounds in the first half.
I'm not sure there's any way to stop Bobby Phils scoring offensively as well. We want to remind you right now, the Jim O'Brien Show will be tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. live in our studios at Television 7 on Wilmington Pike. If you would like to be a part of our audience, we have free tickets available to you. Call right now at the studio, 259-2111. That number is in the phone book. Call right now, and you can get free tickets and come down and even ask a question to Jim O'Brien on the Jim O'Brien Show tomorrow at 11:30 as we look back at this game against Southern.
Look at the Flyers scoring quickly is what we have right now. Dayton being led by Chip Jones has 16 points, and Alex Robertson is also in double figures with 13 points. Of course, Bobby Phils has 20. And this guy, if you've watched him in the first half, you can realize that he is an outstanding shooter, and he shoots very well just off the pass. He gets the pass, turns it, and flips it up.
Phenomenal, the way he can grab the ball, get good grip on the ball, and just turn around and shoot a bullseye. I'm not sure they're really going to stop Phils in the second half, but they have to defend him well. This was a great play, the slam dunk by Al Sicard. Great dish from Sean Scrutchins that opened up that, and that's the kind of play that really ignites the arena and ignites the crowd.
Take a look at some of the team statistical numbers as we have them for you in the first half. The Flyers shooting not too bad. They're shooting 49% from the field and 63% from the free throw line. Southern, on the other hand, is shooting 42%, but they are 9 out of 10 from the free throw line. There you see the rebounding discrepancy. Both teams have turned it over a total of 13 times. Three-point shooting, the Flyers have made 10 out of 21, and that is a good, that the 10 made is a good game for the Flyers, not a half.
Absolutely.
Seven on the other side, six out of 17. They are not shooting well from three.
But right on course for their average. They're averaging 36% from three-point range, so they are right on their season average through four games. Take a look at the individual scores for Dayton. Jones, 16. Again, his career high is 19. Alex Robertson, a good first half. He has 13. Greavy with 9. Coffey with 6. Howard with 5. And David Brad's right before the half fired in a 3. For Southern, we talked about Bobby Phils, 20 points. He is their big gun. Youngblood has 14. Youngblood averages 24, so he's in range to get his average. But again, if Dayton can wear down the Jaguars in the second half here, the Flyers can give Jim O'Brien his 100th career win as a college coach, and we're about ready for the second 20 minutes of basketball.
Both teams getting final instructions. 63-61 is our score, and yes, we are only at halftime.
You know, Southern has Xavier coming to their place now later next week. Southern has won 19 straight games on their home court, seventh best winning streak in the nation for Division I college basketball. They play well in front of the home crowd. Xavier's going to find that out.
I don't think I'd want to play this team in Baton Rouge. Dayton has won 13 straight on this court. They're looking to make it 14 in a row here this evening. Southern will get the ball to start the second half. Here comes Bobby Phils over right in front of us. And I'll tell you, aside from being an outstanding shooter, this guy is just one great-looking athlete.
Absolutely, great muscles. We didn't mention, he was the athlete of the week for the SWAC player of the week last week for the SWAC, the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
The Southern with the ball. Here's Phils, bringing around the horn. Outside, almost stolen away. Harper, nice dish inside. Youngblood the basket.
Southern basket, Robert Youngblood.
And we're tied at 63. Alex Robertson on the move. They kick it back outside. The Flyers will reset. Chip Jones for three. Too hard. Whistle, foul called. It's going to be on Youngblood for pushing off. Robert Youngblood picked up the personal foul.
And I'm starting to get the impression that these guys get away with as much as they can. Watch what he's doing. Kind of just giving a little bit of a nudge.
There you got it.
Trying to get his position. I think the Southern plays that way across the board. Get away with what you can.
Dukes looking for somebody. There's Wes Coffey. Tries to force it inside and tried to force it a little bit too fine.
I thought it was actually a pretty good pass. I don't think Jones thought it was coming. Wes Coffey not wanting to make those crisp passes. He tried it there.
In that situation, I don't know what Chip would have done with the ball where he got it. He was underneath the basket. There's a foul. It's going to be on Dukes before the shot.
An ongoing challenge to stop Phils because once he explodes with the basketball, you don't know if he's going to suddenly pull up and shoot over you or go right around you. In this case, he was going for the baseline, and he simply beat Dukes.
Common foul before the shot. There's Ben Jones. Standing basketball, coach. Won three straight conference titles. Thrown inbounds, almost stolen away. Phils has it. Oh, and it got in his face that time. Gets it back. Nice feed, and Youngblood lays it in. So the Flyers have been outscored 4-0 here in the second half. They trail by two. Alex Robertson has it stolen away. Lazy pass taken from it. Harper down the lane. Scoops it up. No good. Duke loses it out of bounds. It's off his leg.
Derek Dukes is claiming that the ball did not go off of him, but instead went off of Harper, but the referees did not see it that way. Fresh bodies checking in for Dayton.
I didn't see it that way either. I saw it bounce right off his leg. Fresh five coming back into the ballgame for the Flyers, so Jim O'Brien wasting no time getting what was a little bit of a lackadaisical starting five out of there and a new five in. 65-63, Southern by two. An injured player over in the corner. Harper must have taken a shot in the mouth. Walking around, looks to be okay.
Southern's one loss was to UAB Alabama Birmingham, 107-83. They beat them because they beat Southern on the offensive glass.
Southern will set it up. They lead by two. There's Phils. Greavy's got him. Calling for a pick, and he gets it. Fadeaway jumper for three. No good. Brad the rebound.
Good power rebound by David Brads. Bad shot by Phils.
Greedy outside. He thought about a long three. Didn't take it. Green's in trouble. Gives it to Scrutchy. Bounce pass into McCord. Fadeaway jump shot. No good. Gets his own rebound. Back up and in.
Nice job by McCurshiak. He did not give up. He went and followed his shot and got an easy dink.
We're tied at 65. Harper looking inside to Youngblood. Spins on Howard and scores. Youngblood has 20. He scored all 6 points. Up high, Brad's wide open.
Nice pass. Nice pass. Tanks almost deflected that, but Brad caught it and put it right in.
Harper to Williams for three. No good. Rebound Scrutchy. Sean looking up the court. There's Brad. David Brad. The Giac stolen away. Here comes Tanks to Harper. Harper down the lane, scoops and scores.
Good body control by Harper. Scrutchy set up for position, but Harper just looped right around him.
69-67, Southern by two. Scrutchy penetrates the lane, scoops it up and scores.
Nice move. I was just going to mention, good steal by David Braz, and he puts it in.
Flyers get the lead back, 71-69. The pressure starting to pay off. Harper looking around. There's Youngblood. Wide open is Harper. Baseline draws the foul, misses the shot. McCore gets him. His second.
The one thing I would point out for our viewers at home, first let's look at this replay. This is the foul on Shiak. Let's watch and see how the guards for Dayton play in the second half. Let's watch and see how many times you think, ooh, there's a good pass because they're penetrating and opening things up inside. That's the key to the second half. Now, Gretchen's last pass was simply just a great move by a guard to be able to get that in the hoop, going to the hoop like that.
Shooting right into the student section.
Harper has scored 12.
Harper's a good free throw shooter, 80% coming into this ball game.
71-70 is our score. Flyers up by one. 17 minutes and 12 seconds left to play in the ballgame. We hit the pair and we're tied. Full court pressure. Comes into Shiak. McCoy's in trouble. Stolen away. No, gets it back. Howard. And now Howard throws it away. Sean Scrutchy couldn't catch it.
That's not what UD wants. They don't want McCurshiak and Sam Howard playing catch in the backcourt. They need to get it to one of the guards.
All tied at 71. Southern with the ball. In it comes to Youngblood against Shiak. Spins on him. Scores on him.
There's Youngblood putting the ball on the floor, throwing his behind into the defender and getting good position on him.
Loose ball out of bounds. It's Dayton.
Ooh. That could have been off of David Brad's, but the Flyers catch a break, I believe.
Here comes a fresh five back into the ballgame. It's the starting unit back in there.
Youngblood's got 20 points, four shy of his season average.
Alex Robertson triggering it inbound. Flyers trail by two, 73-71. Sakar to Coffey. West in the lane. Gets it to go. Who gets the basket? Jones gets that basket on the tip.
That might have went in anyway.
Jones has 18. We're tied at 73. Inside, Youngblood tipped out of his hand. It's off Dayton.
Nice job by Alex Robertson, and that's what they said to do. As soon as Youngblood gets the ball, give him help. Give the defender some help. In this case, Wes Coffey, and that's what Robertson did.
Outside to Bobby Phil. That's in his range, believe it or not. He'll shoot through. Harper. Flyers doing a nice job so far on Phil's here in the second half. Williams, he'll pull up for the three. Way too hard. Duke tips it around and Alex Robertson tracks it down.
Dayton knows Southern will take bad shots if you give him aggressive defense.
Skip Jones, great feed inside. Gets hammered. Robert Youngblood gets called for his second personal foul. Youngblood, watching right here, just banging the guard with the body.
I'd like to see Dayton get some more balls inside because I think that Southern isn't too smart about when they're fouling. I mean, we saw Tanks pick up three with 8 minutes into the ball game, so I wonder how smart they are inside.
Inbounds it comes. Alex Robertson, a rainbow three, no good. And Tanks with a rebound. Two on two. Here comes Southern. Harper dishes it outside to Bobby Fields for three.
Phil's found his way out. Long pass down court.
Jones to the bucket, scoops it in. Holy cow, that was a great play. Chip Jones was just trying to draw a foul. He wasn't really trying to make that shot. He was trying to draw the foul. 76-75, Southern by one. Harper to the basket, scoops it up, no good. Coffey the rebound and throws it away.
Dayton needs to stay in control. Jim O'Brien, not too happy about that.
Timeout on the floor. 15 and a half minutes left to play. It's Southern 76, Dayton 75. 76-75. Flyers trail by one, but they are cutting the rebound margin closer and closer. In the second half, Dayton has seven rebounds. Southern has one.
And I believe you said earlier that at one point Southern had them 11 to nothing. Great comeback in the rebound statistic for Dayton.
Flyers still down by one right now. Bobby Fills with the ball. Fills looking inside. There's Harper wide open. Dishes back outside to Williams. He puts it on the floor. Bad shot. Dukes the rebound. Derek Dukes to Chip Jones. Jones thinks about three, then blows by his man.
Big time play. That is why Dayton recruited Chip Jones. He exploded past the defender.
That's a great move by Chip Jones. 77-76, Flyers by one. Stolen away, but gets it back. Youngblood to Harper. Harper in trouble. Gets to Youngblood, shoots it up and in. Youngblood has 6 points here in the second half. He has 24 for the game.
Extreme soft touch. Jim O'Brien is chewing the referee right now.
Chip Jones in the corner. Alex for three. No good. Sicard misses the rebound. Southern with a one-point lead in the basketball. 78-77. Under 15 minutes to play.
Sheock and Brazel will check back in next chance.
Harper looking inside. There's Youngblood again. And Chip Jones gets him on the arm.
As soon as Youngblood gets the ball, the defenders know to try to slap at the ball and knock it away. That's what happened here. Jones comes over to help Al, and he commits the foul. Chip Jones, by the way, a career-high 20 points.
Scrutchen's back in the ball game. Sheock in the game, along with David Braz. Go Flyers, go Krogering, where you really do get the best for a whole lot less.
Must be a lot happier with Dukes and Scrutchen's. Kenny Branch seeing very little time at the point tonight.
Robert Youngblood trying to build on a one-point Southern lead.
Shooting into the UD section.
He gets it. Youngblood has 25 points. There's a steal. Harper to the bucket. Tried to draw the foul and nothing there.
3-on-2 for Dayton.
Crushes, deals it outside. Chip Jones for three. Short with it. Almost got the steal back. Here comes Southern. In the corner, Youngblood, 15-footer, short. Back up and in by Tanks.
Threw an air ball, but Tanks saved him.
81-77. Jones to the basket. Blows by his man and puts it in.
They need to start getting the ball into Chip Jones' hand because he's got a hot hand, he's feeling confident, and he is showing that he can go past anybody.
81-79, Flyers down by two. They led by two at half. Bobby Fills, a tough shot there. Defenders all over him. Williams, the rebound, blocked. Shots missed, batted around. Youngblood puts it back in.
Horrible on Dayton's part. They gave him four shots. Offensive boards, Dayton not doing a good job on that end.
27 for Youngblood. Scrutchen's loses it out of bounds. John Scrutchen's lost it out of bounds. It looked like a Southern player had a hand on it the whole time. They've got a four-point lead in the basketball. 13 and a half minutes left to play. That's Williams. Derek Williams.
David Braz has the job of dogging Fills.
Offensive foul on Derek Williams, his third.
Williams trying to penetrate laterally here and comes extremely hard, throws the shoulder into Al Sicard, and it is an offensive foul.
Nice job by Al to take that charge. Norm Grevy's back in. Here comes Sam Howard back in the ballgame. Jim O'Brien is really working the officials here tonight.
I'm not sure what he's discussing. It might still be that Sean Scrutchen's ball that went out of bounds, but he's been on him for about 3 minutes. Now he's working the other one.
I think one thing he wants them to do is leave the ball alone. They make a shot. Foul inside as McCourt takes it to the basket. One thing the Southern players are doing when they make a basket is they'll slap the ball once it comes through the net so they can set up their defense. You do that enough times, you'll get a technical foul. That foul is on Youngblood. Quickly, Robert Youngblood has three here in the second half.
And again, Dayton may want to start getting the ball inside and see if they can get both Tanks and Youngblood out of this game.
Big McCoy is the best free throw shooter on this Flyer basketball team.
Through three games.
Through four games.
Four games.
He's 1-for-2 tonight. 83% for the year.
Free throws could win this game down the stretch.
83-81, Southern up by two. Harper goes inside to Youngblood. He's triple teamed. Somebody's open. It's Harper.
Nice play.
Harper has 15. Flyers on the run. Stretches on the drive. Kicks it out. Greavy partially blocked his shot. Bobby Phil's got the shot, Nick. And yeah, Youngblood, great hustle, but he stepped out of bounds.
That's a break for Dayton. That could have put Southern up by 6 points. The pass was a little bit too long, and Youngblood did a good job to try to control it, but he did hit the line.
I tell you, these referees are real close to giving somebody a technical. Robert Youngblood didn't like the call. He didn't throw the ball to the official. He threw it away from everybody. They're real close to getting a T on somebody.
See if Dayton can get a three to get back in this. Cut it to one.
85-81. Flyers down four. There's Greavy for three. That's short. Rebound, Sheehock back up and in.
Nice job by McCoy. He's crashing the boards. Has to happen.
85-83 Southern. Bobby Phil thinks about a three, tries to draw the foul, tough shot, tip up no good, tipped again and in.
Unbelievable.
Lincoln Browder.
Dayton not having good position. Bad pass by Duke.
Duke throws that one away. Here's Browder to Harper. Harper to the basket for two more. And the Flyers throw it away again. 89-83 Southern.
Welcome back to the UD Arena. Stay tuned to Television 7 after the game. A brand new CBS series called You Take the Kids. It's up at 10 o'clock, followed by Lenny at 10:30. Then it's New Center 7 at 11 o'clock. All here on the Miami Valley News Leader.
Flyers running into a new problem right here in the second half. They have turned it over 10 times in the first eight minutes of the ballgame. Second half.
Foul trouble for Southern. Youngblood 3, Tanks 4. And Derek Williams, or Tanks 3 rather, and Derek Williams 4.
89-83, Southern by 6. They have the ball. As Phil's with it, he's only scored 3 here in the second half. The troublemaker has been Robert Youngblood. He is 13. Phil, great shot. 81-83, Southern by 8. Duke kicks it outside, up top. That's Sam Howard, puts it on the floor. Duke down low, straight shoots, misses the shot, but a foul on Tanks, and Big Dwayne has 4.
I don't know if we can get a shot on number 15, guys, Irwin Harper. He's the guy that I think took a shot. Duke's making a nice strong move to the basket. He'll shoot too. Number 15, Irwin Harper, has some kind of Band-Aid or something on his lip. Or in his mouth. I can't get a good shot of it from where I'm at, but he took a shot earlier, and he's still playing with a bandage now.
Looks like either a mouthpiece or maybe a wad of cotton inside his mouth. Duke's at the free throw line. Derek has scored 1 point. 91-84.
Phil's only 5 points in this second half, yet Youngblood has really poured it on, and he's kind of picked up the slack.
James Wagner's into the ball game, replacing Dwayne Tanks. Flyers have done a nice job on Tanks. He only has 8 points. Missed free throw. Duke's almost got it back. 91-84, 7-point Southern lead. 11 minutes left to play in the ballgame. Harper to Phil. Up top, Harper's got it, penetrates it. The jump shot put up and in.
Good ball work to open that shot up. Good
Lincoln
passing.
Browder has 4. Here's Duke penetrating. Out to Chip Jones, now back in the corner. That's Sheock working in the lane. Fake, shoot, score. McCore Sheock playing a good game inside tonight for Dayton. McCore has 10. It's a 7-point deficit for the Flyers. Inside it goes. Wagner, bad shot there, tipped around. Robertson comes out with it. Great. Alex Robinson to Chip Jones. Blocked. Knocked out of bounds at Dayton ball. Great block that time by Harper.
Great defense at the other end also, because as soon as Youngblood got the ball, the Flyers all helped out, rebounded, and now they got the ball at the other end.
Al Sicard coming in for Sam Howard. There you see Derek Dukes, the trigger man, throwing it inbounds to Sheock. He'll try three. McCore misses. Alex Robertson the rebound. Once goes up, scores it. It counts. No, it doesn't count.
The foul was before he goes into a shooting, so they will call that a common foul.
There's the foul right there. That's continuation in the NBA, but it's a common foul in college basketball.
Mike, this game reminds me a little bit of last year's Southern game here. Dayton trailing by 7 or 8 down the stretch.
Thrown in, stolen away. Oh, he's traveled. No call, though. But he missed the shot. Dipped around. Loose ball and score. Lincoln Browder. Alex Robertson gets lazy with it and loses it.
This game is slowly getting away from 95-86, 10:08 to play.
Flyers down by 9. Harper in the backcourt against Robertson. Inside. Youngblood going for the jam, and he's fouled by Sheehan.
Right now, Dayton needs to regroup, needs to get their defense back in sync. McCore's got to get position and cut off the baseline on that, and he just got burned.
West Coffey's back in. McCore's done a nice job. He's scored 8 of his 10 points here in the second half. Looking for that new or used car, make sure to visit your Lincoln Mercury dealer today or tomorrow. Youngblood misses a free throw. He'll have one more. He scored 27 points. Averages 24.
His career high, 37 against Miles College.
Flyers down by 10, 96-86. Chip Jones gets a stop whistle. Foul called underneath.
Wagner.
Wagner gets his second real quick, and that is 17 fouls on Southern. With 10 minutes to play, the Flyers are going to be shooting the bonus.
If they hit that 10 mark, that can be a plus for the Flyers also. They'll get to shoot 2 every foul committed after that.
Wes Coffey at the free throw line. He scored 6. Get a pair of free throws.
37% shooter. But he gets that one.
The key to shooting good free throws is to be relaxed, and Wes certainly looks relaxed. He almost looks bored there at the free throw line.
Let's see if the Dayton press can make some things happen.
Phil goes high to get it. They'll set it up to Harper. Harper penetrates. Harper throws it away, or they call an offensive foul.
Harper threw himself in the air, really had no body control, and landed right on top of Coffey, so it's an offensive foul. He committed himself in the air and had nowhere to go with the ball.
Harper does that all the time. And Wes Coffey's going to be back at the line for free throws.
Again, free throws, and this doesn't take brain surgery to know this. Free throws could win this game for Dayton in light of the foul situation.
That is a wad of cotton that Harper has in his mouth. He keeps bringing it out. He must be bleeding on the inside of his mouth. Coffey banks in a free throw.
And I think he'll tell us after the game he meant to.
Well, they all count. Ref, with four in a row from the line, and the Flyers now trail by six, 96-90. Crowder in the corner. There's Phil. Bobby Phil for three. He has 28. It's a 9-point lead for Southern. Wrong man has the ball. Bobby gives it up. There's Derek Duke. The card. Oh, they throw it away again. 99-90. Flyers getting careless. They trail by nine. Can't afford to do that.
9 minutes to play. Look at the turnovers. 10 more by Dayton. 26.
Youngblood, baseline jumper. Good.
Robert Youngblood
has 30. And it's an 11-point lead for Southern. Their biggest of the night. Dukes penetrates. Dishes. Alex Robertson for three. No good. Rebound comes down to Youngblood. Here comes Southern, the alley-oop lob for two to Bobby Phils. He has 30.
Great execution.
You got to believe Jim O'Brien might need a timeout, but he's not going to get it right now. Alex is open for three again. He cans it.
Dayton needs to hit some threes. Brad's and Greedy getting ready to check back in. That's the only way to cut a 10-point deficit.
Stolen away. Chip Jones couldn't control it. It's out of bounds. Substitutions. Greavy, Brads, Howard, Sheehock, and Stretches. A fresh five back in the lineup.
It's important that Dayton play a near flawless final 8 minutes and 24 seconds. That's the only way you make up a 10-point deficit against a team as athletic as Southern.
103-93. They'll bring it out front to Mac Guillory. He's giving Harper a breather. Harper's been trouble here in the second half. There's Youngblood again. Whistle. Travel.
And a break for Dayton. A great player Youngblood is with his back to the basket. He's very talented.
David Brads looking inbound. Somebody's got to be open. Got the timeout. Timeout on the floor. Southern 103, Dayton 93. We'll be right back.
Southern likes to showcase, we'll show you that in a minute, tomorrow, Falcons and Browns here on Television 7 at 1 o'clock with CBS. The Browns looking to turn things around. Watch this pass, Harper to Phils, and yes, the Jaguars like the showtime, 30 points for Phils.
Flyers will inbound it. They couldn't get it in, that's why they called the timeout. 103-93. We have 8 minutes and 15 seconds left to play in the ballgame. The Flyers down by 10.
We said before the game this was a gut check for the Flyers after getting blown out by Miami. Time to get a gut check here.
Sam Howard in trouble. Flyers almost lose it. Loose ball on the floor, and it's tracked down by Southern, and a foul on Sam Howard.
Dayton not handling the Southern press well at all.
Second straight game that the Flyers have given up 100 points.
And it looks like Southern can hit their average of 123 with 8 minutes left to play. Dayton has already hit their average.
But unlike the Miami game a week ago, Dayton still has a chance in this game. Down the lane, Phil scoops it up and in.
Complete open highway for him. No defender got in his way.
Dayton almost throws it away again. Scrutchins retains possession in the corner. Creevy for three. Doesn't get the roll, but the rebound for Sheehock back up and in.
Sheehock's having a great second half. I got him at 10 points. Second half.
12 for the game. A 10-point Southern lead. They have the ball. 7.5 minutes left to play. But loses control. It's out of bounds. Southern will inbound and underneath their own basket. Come out front to Bobby Phil. He's looking for a shot. He'll take the shot. No good. Rebound, Youngblood. kicks it back out. There's Wagner, short with it, gets it over. Back up, he scores it, and he's fouled.
We said earlier, if Southern controls the offensive boards, Dayton is done. And right now, this is a bad time for the rebounding to fall apart for the Flyers.
107-95. Flyers going to make some changes. Four fresh faces in the lineup. David Brad's picked up that foul, his first. One of the nice things about Cellular One, you can get toll-free calls to all 50 states during the holidays. Free throw missed and Tiak rips it off the board. Flyers down by 12. Points in a hurry. 7 minutes and 15 seconds left to play. Duke's in trouble. To Jones. Chip down the lane. Puts it up and in. Nice move by Jones. And you notice nobody's leaving the arena after what O'Brien did to him last year in the same Southern game. This crowd needs to get into it, though. 107-97, almost a steal by Duke. Fields inside, stolen away. Here comes Duke. Duke has a man. It's Jones. Pulls up and scores. Two in a row by Chip Jones. Long pass down court. Flyers within eight. 107-99. Here comes the crowd. That's Browder, Lincoln Browder, the free shot, no good. Deox the rebound. Dayton on the run with it. Duke drive. Duke goes. Unbelievable drive by Derek Duke. He saw the hole and went right for it. Great. The Flyers have scored six in a row, and Southern once. 101. We'll be right back. Derek Duke's given Flyer fans a reason to look forward to his next 3 years here. Great move straight through the middle. Goes up and over the defender. Beautiful. Flyers have scored six straight points. They trail by six. 107-101. And now the press has to work, Mike. 12,727. Starting to come to life. Youngblood, fake, shoot, that's short. Rebound, Derek Duke. Duke, inside feed, slapped away. Jones gets it back. Skip, pulls up, shoots, no good. Almost walked with it. Rebound to Tank. Now they'll set it up. Matt Guillory will set it up. Flyers, buckling down on the defensive end. Guillory. Williams, he's been quiet in the second half. Hasn't scored. Bills and Youngblood play a two-man game. It's blocked. Great block by Al Sakar. Duke spins. Loses the ball. Loose ball on the floor. Williams has it. Flyers got to get back defensively. Guillory to Youngblood. It's blocked, but a foul. Alex Robertson had a hand all over it. Take another look at it. Did he get the ball or did he get the arm? He got both. Blown opportunity by Dayton after the blocked shot. You got the arena into the game and you got a great defensive effort. Dukes really needs to make the right pass or get the ball in the hoop to get this crowd or keep the crowd in it, rather. That's a missed opportunity. 17 fouls now on the Flyers, so it's bonus for everybody. 5:16 left to play. The UD crowd behind the basket not shaking Youngblood on that one. Robert Youngblood, 31 points. His career high is 37. He missed that one. 7-point lead. 108-101. Flyers with the ball. Duke. Out front to Jones. Inside to Shiak. Turn, shoot, score! Shiak has to be near a career high if he hasn't already hit it. McCorr with 14 points. He's got 15 for a career. Youngblood has a shot blocked, but he's fouled. Kip Jones called for the foul, and you're seeing a definite pattern now. Every time Southern comes up, they're kicking it inside to Robert Youngblood. He has the hot hand.
And Dayton doing a good job there, as you saw on the instant replay, of collapsing. Jim O'Brien needs scrappiness out of his team right now. That's the only way to force turnovers and get back in this. They were down by 10. Now they're down by 5 with 4:45 to play, 108-103.
Youngblood with 2. Misses that one.
Only a 63% shooter from the free throw line, and hopefully that UD crowd is shaking him up a little bit. Staring into the sea of red and white and a drum to beat.
He gets that one, has 32, and it's a 6-point lead again. Flyers need some help. Just got it inbounds to Alex Robertson. Robertson on the dribble to Chip Jones, open for 3. Misses the shot, Sicard the rebound, tip, no good. Guillory to Fills, Bobby Fills. Williams will set it back up. A 6-point lead, 4.5 minutes left to play. Southern with the ball, and they're going to be patient. Phil, this is the 3. It goes over the backboard, out of bounds. It'll be Dayton ball.
Again, that was not a smart shot at all by Phil. He's a great scorer. He's averaging close to 38. But in that situation, as time ticks down, why fire a shot from 24 feet out? Dayton fans aren't complaining.
Flyers get a fresh 5 back in the ballgame. Wes Coffey, Sam Howard, Sean Strutchins, Norm Grevy, and David Brad.
The critical player to watch, Sean Strutchins. How will he run the offense with Dukes out of the game?
Strutchins with the ball right now. Flyers down by 6. Strutchins on the dribble. Bounce pass inside, stolen away, bad pass. Youngblood was there to pick it off.
And a rarity to see Southern walking up the court.
Bobby Fills. Southern's going to spread it out outside for a minute, working around. Youngblood wants the ball. He's crying for it down there. There he gets it. Youngblood misses an easy one, and Grevy has the rebound. Grevy on the move. That's crushing. That's line. That's an offensive foul. John Strutchin's trying to do just way too much right now.
And he's going to come out of the ball game. Dukes and the fresh 5 come back in. Dayton has depth, but the depth has to execute. Take a look. Sean just playing a little bit out of control. He didn't have to go right in on the baseline, and consequently an offensive foul that the Flyers cannot afford.
Exactly. 3.5 minutes left to play in the ballgame. Dayton down 109-103.
The Flyers need an offensive 3 when they get the ball back to fire this crowd back up.
Alex Robertson knocks it away right here on press row.
Great hands. Alex Robertson will lead this team in deflections and steals.
Guillory against Dukes. Derek playing right there with him. Spins around him. Guillory to the basket. Scoops it up. No good for the foul. Offensive. Guillory called for the charge.
And again, this isn't a knock. I hope it isn't a knock against Southern, but we're not seeing smart play by the guards. They're committing themselves in the air and making offensive fouls that just aren't real smart. Right now, the possession arrow as we go into the final 3 minutes is pointing towards Dayton.
109-103. Flyers have free throws coming. Now the guard is going to be at the line.
The way Dayton's played, Mike, in the last 3 minutes, especially with that quick run with Strutchins in the game, it's amazing. If Al hits these 2 free throws, they're only down 4.
And important to note, that is the 9th team foul on Southern. So from here on out, every foul is a 2-shot automatic foul. Descartes misses that one.
Critical miss.
Flyers blowing some key chances. Coming up to 3 minutes to play. Bobby Fills bounces out top. Southern trying to be patient with it. They're trying because it's not easy for this team. Inside the tank. Tank spins, shoots, no good. Rebound battled for. Youngblood was over the back, but no call. And the Flyers get the rebound. Robertson. Cross court to Jones. Chip
hit it.
Three. No good. Jones couldn't buy the bucket. A wide open 3. 109-103, 2:25 left to play. Southern trying to slow it down. Guillory in the corner to Youngblood. He passes up a shot. Southern's going to be patient now. Set it up as a foul out front on Alex Robertson.
Dayton fouls on number 24, Alex Robertson, is third.
Play the lottery for the fun of it. You just may win big, too.
Since Derek Williams just became eligible to play, we don't know what kind of free throw shooter he is. No stats on him from the line.
So far tonight, he's 2 for 2, so he's 100%. He'll go to the line. 109-103, Southern.
It's been a while since Dayton scored.
Misses that one badly.
The Jaguars are giving the Flyers every opportunity to get back in this thing, tie it, and win it with 2:12 on the clock.
You get that roll. 9 points.
And the Jaguars back off the press. They're going to try to eliminate the easy basket for Dayton.
And a 7-point lead. There's Grevy thinking about three. He's picked up. Grevy for three. Too hard with it. Loose ball battled for. Southern comes away with it. Dayton's got to shoot the threes to get back in this thing. Under 2 minutes to play.
Ice cold down the stretch.
Bobby Fills, you don't want to foul him. Floating away, Grevy. Gets the steal, then gets it back for two.
Nice job, nice job.
1-10, 105, 138 left to play. Almost thrown away. Williams on the dribble, drive, in trouble, he's fouled.
Good defense by Dayton. Scrappy trying to rattle the man with the ball. They have to do that.
It is a two-shot foul, though, because the Flyers are over the limit. They have 10 personal fouls.
I'll tell you what, I'm not sure if David Brads doesn't commit the foul, if that isn't a traveling, because he had nowhere to go with the ball. Next on 7, you take the kids. Stay tuned.
Derek Williams going to the free throw line.
Derek Williams in the line for Southern, 2 throws.
Again, he misses the first.
Williams does not use his legs when he shoots the ball from the free throw line. He just kind of flips it with his arms.
Williams scores again. 111-105. Flyers need a couple of threes. Under a minute and a half to play. Grevy in trouble. There's Sheehock. Gets it back to Grevy. Norm had a pick. Now to Sheehock. Dayton looking for the three. There it is from Grevy. An air ball.
Made a great effort to try to knock the ball in midair off of the out-of-bounds player for Southern. The referee said no can do.
Here comes Chip Jones back into the ball game, along with Al Sicard and Alex Robertson.
It's been about 3 minutes since Dayton scored.
Flyers need a steal off the press. Whistling a foul, it's Alex Robertson. Alex has 4 now.
So now Southern can win this game with their free throws. This is the third time they've been sent to the line in the last 45 seconds.
Flyers next play at home once again. Wednesday, they'll take on Robert Morris.
There's the foul trouble for Dayton. Sheehock 3, Dukes 3, Scrutchins 3, and Robertson 4. There's timeout on the floor.
Timeout on the floor. 111-105 is our score with 110 left to play in the ballgame. Tonight's broadcast produced and directed by Ron Stevens. Studio director is Bob Roman. The remote technical manager, Jeff Gerhardt. Unit engineer in charge is Chuck Wright. And our thanks to our technical crew as well, bringing you Dayton Flyer basketball on WHIO-TV Dayton Springfield.
Well, I've said it twice before tonight, Mike. This game is a gut check for Dayton. The way the three-point works in college basketball now, 111-105 with a minute 10 to play, is not too much to overcome, but Dayton has had a cold hand. It's been about 3 minutes since they've been able to score, either from the free throw line or from the field.
Flyers have only 1 3-point basket in the second half. They had 10 in the first half.
Southern made a nice adjustment at halftime to close off the 19-footers and beyond. Very similar to last year's game. The final score last year was 114-105. Right now it's 111-105.
After Robert Morris is in town on Wednesday, The Bradley Braves will host the Flyers next Saturday in Peoria, Illinois.
Southern trying to take a 3-1 lead in the series against Dayton and deny Jim O'Brien again his 100th career win as a college coach.
Derek Williams back to the line. He makes that one. 112-105.
All the three-point shooters are in for Dayton. They will be looking to set up a screen and let one of them fire.
Got missed. It's a 7-point margin right now. Flyers are trying to cut into. Duke to Sicard for three. Way off the mark. Jones gets it back. There's Duke for three. That's short. Jones gets it back. Dukes has it. Derek drives, shoots it up, and scores.
50 seconds to play, 112-107.
Flyers get a timeout. So it's now a matter of fouling and hoping that Southern misses the free throws. 112-107.
I correct myself. I said all the three-point shooters were in. Norm Grady was on the bench, the best free throw shooter for the Flyers. O'Brien, I guess, wanting quickness on the press as opposed to having the three-point threat in there. Brad, Dukes, and Al Sicard can throw it up.
Our next televised game is in Chicago after the first of the year, Thursday, January 10th. We'll be there for Dayton and Loyola.
Take this opportunity, Mike, to extend an open invitation to all Flyer basketball fans. Any Sunday they would like to come down and see the Jim O'Brien Show live at our studios, we welcome you. Give us a call and we will line you up free tickets for the Jim O'Brien Show. Whenever you would want to come down, call us at the studio. Still to come on Television 7 after the game, you take the kids in progress. And at 11 o'clock on News Center 7, we will bring you a complete recap of the day. I correct myself. We will see it in its entirety. You take the kids and then Lenny.
Flyers with one timeout left.
That was a nice steal. Greavy deflected it into the hands of Dukes. Dukes had a nice bounce pass back to Greavy, and it was a two. 112-107, 5 minutes to play. 50 seconds to play, rather, sorry.
Jim O'Brien working the sidelines. Southern gets it in to Bobby Phils, and quickly there's a foul.
Not the man to foul, either.
Not the guy you want to foul. He shoots 87%.
Now the three-point shooters check back in. What O'Brien will do here in the final 48 seconds, if timeouts and fouls permit, he'll keep switching in his defensive teams and his offensive teams.
Bobby Phils has 32 points. He and Robert Youngblood have combined for 64 of the 112 Southern points.
Dayton will see Texas Southern and also out of the Southwest Athletic Conference, but you got to like Southern's chance of going to the NCAA, winning that conference.
Second toss up, it's no good. Flyers down by six, need a couple of threes in a hurry. Dukes drives, shoots, and scores. Derek has eight. 35 seconds left on the clock, foul in the backcourt on Brads. David Brads picks up the foul. That'll send Guillory to the free throw line.
Dayton down four, 113-109, 33 seconds to play roughly, 33.6 actually. And right now, Dayton winning is dependent on whether or not Southern can hit their free throws. It's that simple.
Guillory misses the first one.
Chip Jones coming back into the game, and if he misses this one, Mike, we are set for an exciting finish here at the arena.
Guillory misses another one. A 4-point difference, 31 seconds left. Got to push it up. Duke to Jones. Chip for three. Rims it out. No, it goes in. It goes in. Whistle.
Dayton takes the timeout.
Timeout with 21 seconds left. The Flyers are down by one. Chip Jones has 31 points.
That ball he fired up, as you may or may not have seen, rimmed in and went as high as the time clock, the shot clock on top of the backboard, and fell right in. And Dayton needed the three.
Now the Flyers at a major advantage because they can foul. And even if Southern hits two free throws, a three-point basket ties the game.
Watch the penetration down court. I can't believe Jones is this open for a three-pointer. That's a breakdown on Southern's defense, but he hits the 21-footer. Watch how high this thing goes up. Way up there. Not quite as high as the clock, but that was a great shot.
Dayton is now out of timeout. Trailing by one. There you see it from the low angle.
Now, Dayton obviously has to foul quickly. 21 seconds on the clock. Southern needs to get the ball. They have one timeout remaining. Southern needs to get the ball to the likes of Fills or Harper, both shooting 80% or better from the free throw line. If they get the right man, they will go for the trap and hopefully get a clean turnover. But Dayton set for an exciting finish here against Southern, trailing by one.
The crowd coming to its feet.
They will put Wes Coffey on the ball for Southern.
113-112, Southern. Ben Jobe. His team has blown a 12-point lead.
It's Alcicard's job not to get burned back.
Harper fouled in the backcourt by Alex Robertson, and Alex has just fouled out of the game.
A good offensive effort tonight by Robertson.
Personal foul.
I got him at 16 unofficially.
Yep, 13 of those in the first half. Edward Irwin Harper going to the free throw line. He scored 17 points. He's an 80% free throw shooter. Has made 3 out of 4 here tonight.
Norm Grevy checking back into the lineup. Once again, the offensive team is back in, the three-point threat. Now we're in a situation where if the Jaguars hit both of these free throws, Dayton can come down, hit a three, and tie this game. And listen to the arena.
Irwin Harper has 2 shots. He quiets the crowd with that one.
Ice in his veins because this arena is loud.
114-112. He hits a pair,
and Dayton needs a three.
And Southern takes a timeout. Leading 115-112, they are now out of timeouts. 19.7 seconds left on the clock.
Well, we're seeing a great ball game tonight, Mike. Somebody has to lose this game, but both teams will take a lot away from this, and this early on in the season. Dayton lost to Miami. They needed this game to get back on the winning track, and it's going to take a fantastic finish to do so.
Obviously, the Flyers are setting up for a three-point shot. They have to have three. Jim O'Brien talking to his team in the huddle.
This will be a design play, as you mentioned, Mike, where somebody is going to have to lay the effective screen to open up the three-point shot. And how that's executed, we will wait and see. There's the three-point shooting. Dayton, 2 for 20 in the second half. That's horrible. Southern, 2 for 9. So the long-range shooting went south in the second half.
The Flyers have tried 41 threes tonight, made 12 of them. So here we go. Hang on to your hats with just under 20 seconds left to play. Dayton with the ball, trailing by 3.
They want Dukes to bring the ball up court, and he will.
Gotta come in a hurry. Derek Dukes in trouble. There's no timeout, Derek. You don't have a timeout, do you? Did the Flyers have a timeout?
I don't believe so.
That's a technical foul because Dayton didn't have a timeout, and that is a very big freshman mistake right there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You have to be aware of what is left. When you have no timeouts left, you have to know that. He had Norm Grevy wide open across court from us in front of the scorer's table. That is the price you pay when you have a young team, and it's going to happen sometimes. And Derek Dukes will hear about that one after the game.
Al Sakai is going to check in, but almost a foregone conclusion with 10 seconds left. Southern has free throws coming.
And the ball.
And then the ball back. Pressure defense really doing the job for the Southern Jaguars. They really put the pressure on.
Score.
Jim O'Brien, helpless right now.
You can teach and you can teach all week long, especially the fundamentals and the mental toughness and the smartness that goes along with being able to put the ball in the basket. And sometimes what just happened will happen and the coach is helpless.
Free throws coming for Irwin Harper. Missed that one badly.
Jim O'Brien saying, don't give up. He's shouting encouragement.
One free throw here by Harper would just about woodlock it up. And there it is. Harper now has 20. Southern gets the ball right here in front of us. They lead by four. 116-112. Stolen away. Kenny Branch. Bring it outside. No. Stolen away again. Dukes. Oh, the Flyers have thrown it away. Phil shoots it up with 1 second left. There's the ball game. Dayton has lost it by a final score of 116-112. We'll be back to wrap it up in just a minute.